prayers right here on the altar, and we study them no more. God, we thank you that we have a friend in Jesus who can handle all of our cares, who can handle all of our burdens. And so right now, as we come and touch and agree, not only for our own personal needs, but for the hand that we hold, for the person on the phone, for the persons in the hospital, we lift them up in the name of Jesus. You can open new doors. You can give a bridge over trouble scenarios. So God, right now, we commit ourselves unto you. We commit these situations unto you. And Satan, the Lord rebuke you. We plead the blood of Jesus over every person, over every family, under the sound of my voice. The blood of Jesus. And we thank you that we know that the blood still works. So God, as we are being covered by the blood, we stand in affirmation not only of a week of thanksgiving, but every day is a day of thanksgiving. Bless our travel. Bless our fellowships. Bless our memories. Bless our mourning. Bless even our grief. And we claim victory for everyone right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, in advance. Thank you in advance for the healing, the breakthrough. Thank you in advance. Hear our prayers, we pray. Incline your ear unto us and grant us your peace. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Put those happy hands together. Give the Lord a praise offering as you return to your seat. whenever it comes. Though we are only 42 days left before ending 2017, I come to tell somebody on today, there is still time for God to do it. God is still on the throne, and he hasn't given up on you, and you don't dare give up on him. It doesn't matter how long you have had this problem. The power of God is still able to turn it around. I'm here to tell somebody, there is still time for God to do it. I know that you think you made a mistake in making a public resolution in December of last year of what you were going to expect God to do in this year. And now that this year is almost ending, people are looking at you strangely because you said that this year was going to be your best year. And from the outside looking in, it appears that it's your worst year. People are looking at your circumstance, and you told folk, as you testified last December the 31st, that this time, this year, you would be in a different position. Financially, physically, spiritually, come on somebody. And now you find yourself almost in December, and your circumstance appears to be the same way they were last year. I stop by to tell somebody, there is still time for God to do it. God can do what seems to be impossible. In fact, he loves impossible situations. I serve a God who takes the impossible and make possibilities out of them as long as we learn how to trust him first. Come on, somebody. God still has time to turn your thing around that you've been dealing with for the past year. That thing that still is on your back, that monkey that still is in your consciousness, that weird old thing that's still in your subconsciousness, there is still time for God to do it. Not only is God able, but God is also willing to work this thing out in the next 42 days that's remaining in this year. And no matter how long it's been, you cannot give up. I'm not going to tell you to turn to nobody and tell them don't give up, but you ought to look at yourself and say, self, don't give up. There's, see, y'all playing with it like we in school, and the teacher telling you, no. Self, don't give up. There's still time for God to do it. Even though the stack is high, despite the diagnosis, God can turn it around. There's still time for you to be empowered. Empowered to love. Empowered to give. Empowered to forgive. Empowered to be healed. There is still time. There is still time for God to see you through. Still time for God to give you peace in the midst of the storm. There's still time for God to calm the roaring lion. There's still time for God to restore and to replenish. There's still time for God to give you good health and prosperity. There is still time for God to replace your sadness with gladness. There's still time for you to reap what you have sown. There's still time to be happy and fall in love. There's still time to complete the goals that God gave you in December of last year. There's still time for God to do it. I know that the enemy is trying to tell you that God's time is almost completed. But how many of you know that in the scripture of Ecclesiastes, he says that there's a time for everything? Oh, come on, somebody. There is an appointed time for everything. And there's a time for every event under the heaven. A time to give birth. A time to die. A time to plant. A time to uproot what is planted. A time to heal. A time to be healed. A time to tear down, a time to build up. There's a time to weep, and there's a time to laugh. There's a time to mourn, and there's a time to dance. There's a time to throw stones, and there's a time to gather stones. There's a time to embrace, and there's a time to shun embracing. There's a time to search, and there's a time to give up as lost. There's a time to keep. There's a time to speak. There's a time to love. There's a time to hate. There's a time for war. There's a time for peace. There is an appointed time, and there's a time for everything under the heaven. Can I bring it down a notch to remind us that God is the only one who appoints the times and the seasons? God is the one. These words are for every person in every place, in every circumstance. God has appointed the times and the seasons, the events of our lives. We can plan, but God appoints. You can plan, but God sets the appointment. Amen, somebody. The events of our lives, the happy events, the sad events, the easy events, the difficult events. On one hand, this can bring worry, but on the other hand, it should bring us hope, because we know that God is still in control. Amen. Somebody shout control. Control. There's a whole lot of control, people who would desire to be in control. But I'm here to tell you that the end result, God is in control. God exalts and humbles the same person. He raises nations up and brings them down. Even the day of our death has been set by God. God is in control. Sometimes you may wonder about that, because there are some things that you have prayed for that seemingly has not gone to your prayer or desire. But God says, don't give up. Even though there's crime, even though the nation is going through, even though there is discouraging scenarios all around us, God is saying, you cannot give up, because I am still under control, and I've got all power in my hand, and there is still enough time in these last 43 days for me to do what you've been waiting on all year. Now, if some of y'all really believe that, I would ask you for a half of a second, give him the kind of praise that makes you believe that God is going to do it before the end is up. God shows up when there is a change in our attitude. God can change some things when we stop worrying about them. God can change some things from the bad to the good when we allow ourselves to experience His grace and His mercy. God can help us with new situations. I've never seen an old mercy. I'll say it again. I've never seen an old mercy. The Bible says they are new mercies. So we're not living in old mercy. We're living right now in the what? God is still able to do, even though there are things that are contradictory to what our desires are, God is still able. Y'all don't get it. Okay. Calm it down, Pastor. Get in your mind what you've been waiting all year for God to do. And the word that God gave me to give to you, that there's still for God. Elohim. Enjoy the right now moment because you're so busy thinking about your grocery list for tomorrow to get ready for next Thursday. Some of you are not living in the right now moment because you still hung over for what did not happen on last night and what did not come together last week. And the last 3 months have been the worst 3 months of your year. And I'm here trying to give you a breakthrough. And you still in old day. You still in yesteryear. And I'm trying to let you know that this is the day that the Lord has made. No. I'm trying to get you to understand that this is the day that the Lord has made. I'm trying to get you to understand that today is the day that the Lord has made, and I shall rejoice and be glad in it today. I can't talk about yesterday because it's gone, and I don't know about tomorrow because it may never come, but this is. You got to learn how to smile today. You got to learn how to love today. You've got to learn how to forgive today. You've got to learn how to apply your faith. You've got to learn how to lift your hands in the sanctuary today. You should make the best of each day and each season of change in our lives, and Lord, learn how to enjoy your children today, and learn how to enjoy your wife, your husband, your lover today. Learn how to enjoy your home today, and learn how to enjoy your health. So when the days that you come
and Arthur won't let you raise your hand. You can think back when you were younger and were able to lift up your hands. Learn how to lift them up while you can today. Y'all ain't got it yet. Y'all ain't got it yet. Learn how to leap for joy today, so you won't become old and evil. And if you can't raise your hand, if you can't jump for joy, you ought to be able to lean your head over every now and then and let us know you're still alive. If you can't lean your head over every now and then, you ought to lean back in the midst of you taking a nap and smile at God. Amen. But you ought to be able to do something. If you can't raise your hand, pat your foot. If you can't pat your foot, nod your shoulder. Amen. But everything that has breath in this room, you ought not take it for granted that you are where you are right now. The Bible says, let everything that hath breath do what? Do what? Give him the best praise. I'm here to tell you, have a seat. I'm here to tell you, I'm almost finished, that there's still time for God to do it. Do you hear what God is speaking right now to you? That thing that you've been worrying about for the last 11 months, there is still time for God to do it. They gave you a notice and told you the deadline is November the 1st, but you're still in there and it's November the 19th. That's grace right there. You ought to be shouting for grace right there. But if God can hold off for 19 days, whatever God needs to do, God can do it in the next 42 days. But you've got to be believing. You've got to have faith to know, I'm going somewhere with this. Stop hollering, Pastor. We've got to learn to trust God to provide all of our needs. You ain't trusting God, you're trusting that check. Y'all already tried that, huh? Let's be real up in here. There are some people right now who are sad because they don't have any money to do what they desire to do for their family. But I'm here to tell you, if you get that sad look off of your face right now and get that empathy look off of your face right now, you don't know who will walk up to you before the end of this service. You don't know who will put something in your hand before you walk out of this door. You don't know who God will lead to say, all of this is yours. And God is doing it just like that. God loves impossibilities. God loves being at the end of the game and folk are on the edge of their seat trying to see who's going to win, who's going to get the last dump, who's going to get the last touchdown. God loves to see who's going to get the last home run, but you've got to have your hands up. even on. I don't even know nothing about games, but I know that much. If I'm going to catch something, I got to be reaching for it. You've got to have your guard up. You've got to know who's around you so that you can get through for the touchdown. I don't have to be sitting there and be worried who's going to be protecting me. All I've got to do is see the goal. The ball is in my hand. I'm not responsible for who's around me. The Bible says that goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. So I've got somebody running with me, goodness and mercy. And then the angel, y'all better get, see? Ain't ready. You don't know who God is going to use to supply your groceries. You sitting there with, look like you're going to start crying. Ain't nobody coming to no crybabies today. You didn't cry long enough. You didn't whine long enough. God is coming to some people who are rejoicing in spite of it and in the midst of it. You sitting there thinking you're getting more attention by, well, no, this ain't the lottery. This is not by osmosis. You can't rub this away. You got to faith this up. You got to praise this up. You got to open up your life and your arms and be ready to receive what's up. Before the end of this service, there's still time for God to do it. So when I leave you with this, there are 10 things, top things you don't worry about in the coming years. And even in these last 42 days especially. Why? Because the Bible still has the answers. Oh my God. I wish y'all could shout just right there. Prayer. Number three, the Holy Ghost still moves. There's still time for God to do it. Number four, the reason why you don't have to worry, because God will still inhabit the praise of his people. God invites himself in where there is praise from his people. So the more you praise him, the more evident God is going to be in the midst of her. Number five, there is still anointing in the preaching. Preaching under the anointing can break your yoke right now. Hallelujah. There is still praise in singing. When you don't know anything else to do, get you a song in your heart and start lifting that song unto the Lord. There is still anointing in preaching. There is still praise in singing. There is still inhabited in the praise. There is still the move of the Holy Spirit. Prayer still works. The Bible still has the answer. Number seven, God will still pour out blessings on his people.